In today's video, I want to share with you 5 key tips and tricks that you can apply while you type or while you write your project, your thesis, or any report of your choice in Microsoft Word, so that you will enhance your experience and you ease the access and the process of writing in Word. Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Rashid and welcome back to Epic Mentorship. Remember to subscribe if you are new here. Let's get started with our tips and tricks for today.
Right guys, so the first tip that I have for us today is actually how to insert page numbers. Okay, page numbers are very, very useful when you are writing your document. It makes it very easy for you to identify what the page you are on and how you can navigate to other pages. Okay, so to insert a page number, all you need to do is to come over here to insert, and then you come down here to page number. Okay, so you have the option to insert at the top of a page. We have different sides, from a plain number to plain number 2, which is at the center, from the left to the center, and you have it to the right, and you have it in text form, right, at the top of the page, okay, and at the top right, top left and top right, okay. So you have it, you can write at the bottom of the page, top, bottom left, center and bottom right, okay, just like that. And then you can have it along the margin sign. You can put in a page number along the margin sign as you wish, and the current position that you put your mouse on, that number can be inserted at that point. Okay, so you can format it to another given format that you want, and lastly you can remove page numbers if you so wish. All right, so let's say at this time we choose a top and center, and you can see it quickly inserts the page numbers at the top. Okay, so you can see, you can move down and you can see page 1, page 2 and page 3. Right, so once you hit this close header and footer, it's going to automatically retain the particular number and footer that the setting you put. Okay, so for example, for this one you select 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we have our pages numbered 1, 2, 3 at the top. Right, the next tip that I have for us actually is how to sort lists in Microsoft Word. How to sort lists in Microsoft Word. It's a very, very easy and handy tool that you can use to sort our given lists within Microsoft Word. For example, you have a list of items or a list of things that we just put in down here, and they are haphazardly arranged, and we want them to be listed accordingly in an ascending or descending order, okay, alphabetically. So all you need to do is to select that particular list, and you come over here to sort, and you click on it, and then you can have, based on what you select, is going to show over here that it's a paragraph and it's a group of text. You have the option to select sorting based on ascending or descending order. It's up to you. For example, I say based on ascending, and when I hit click, it's going to start alphabetically based on the ascending order from the letter A down to letter Z. Okay, and you can do based on descending as well. So the second option is you can have numbering also. When you have numbers haphazardly placed, you can sort them accordingly based on ascending or descending order. So all you need to do is to select them as well, and then move over here and select ascending or descending order. By just looking, you can understand that it selects the paragraph and it shows that they are a group of numbers. Okay, so you are to select whether ascending or descending. So on selecting ascending, it will automatically regroup them in ascending order. So the last example is when you have multiple items and combined with numbers. Okay, yeah, in this case they are separated by a tab, okay, in between them, they're just separated by a tab. So to do this one particularly, you have to convert this whole thing, this whole text, to a table. So to convert to a table, just like in our previous class we showed how to convert from text to table, you have to select the text first, and then you come to insert, and you come to table over here, and then you move down straight to convert text to table. All right, so once you hit it and It will automatically identify that you have two columns. Okay, it will automatically detect that you have two columns. So once you check and you have 13 rows, okay, once you check it's everything is correct, you hit enter and all of these will be converted to a table just like that. Okay, and you have the option to come over here again and it's now sort. Okay, it's at this point you can now sort. Sorting can be in different forms. Okay, it identifies that you have texts, so you can sort by column one. Okay, so you can just sort column one in ascending order and it will automatically drive column two according to column one. Okay, so once you hit enter and it's going to sort column one just like that, and you can sort according to column two also the same way. All right, the next tip that I have for us actually is how to use superscript and subscript, how to assign subscript and superscript within a particular text. Okay, so to do that, there are two ways. Actually, the first one is you can select a particular text that you want to make a subscript, and you come over here to this small arrow, you click on it, and then you have the option to make it a superscript. And once you click OK, it's made a superscript. Okay, and you can do Ctrl Z, and you can do the same thing to make it a subscript, and it just goes as a subscript just like that. Okay. And the second option is actually how to use the control key. So assuming we select this, to make a text a subscript, all you need to do is to control plus, it's going to make it a subscript. Okay, so we do undo, and we want to do a superscript. For you to do a superscript, you have to do control shift plus, and it's going to make it a superscript just like that. So it's a very handy tool and feature that you can use to actually quickly translate or move your text to superscript and subscript as you are working in Microsoft Word. So the next tip that I have for us is actually how to use the control key. I know most of us are aware that the control is a very powerful key that we can use to do so many functions within Microsoft Word. Okay, so the most familiar function of control key is how to copy and paste. We know Ctrl C and Ctrl V to copy and to paste. This is very common within people, right? So the one that is not so common is that you can click a particular place, and when you hold the control and press the forward arrow key, it takes you from one word to another. We move from one word to the next. Okay, forward arrow, one word to the next. And the same thing when you hold the control and use the back arrow key, it's going to take you one word at a time in the backward direction. Okay, one word at a time in the backward direction. When you hold the control key and hit the down arrow, it's going to move you one paragraph at a time. Okay, so you hold the control key and hit the down arrow, you move the paragraph at a time. Okay, you move one paragraph at a time. Okay, when you hold the control key and hit the up key, it's going to move you one paragraph at a time upwards. Okay, control shift plus the down arrow, it's going to select the entire paragraph. Okay, control shift up arrow unhighlights it. Control plus home is going to bring you back to the beginning of the text wherever you are in that particular document, right? Control end is going to take you to the end of that particular document at any given point. When you identify a particular sentence and you hit control and click anywhere within that particular sentence, that sentence is going to be selected just like that, right? All right, so the last tip that I have for us is actually how to use the mouse select tool. Okay, the mouse select tool is a very, very handy and useful feature that you can use in Microsoft Word to select the text accordingly. Okay, for example, when you click on anywhere, it puts that mouse at that particular point. Okay, you click on anywhere, it puts the mouse at that particular point. And when you double click, it selects the word in that place. Okay, once you double click, it selects that particular word. Okay, when you triple click, it selects the whole paragraph. When you triple click, it selects the whole paragraph. While you select a particular text, you can hold the left key and drag that particular text to another place, to another location, and drop it there. Okay, just like that. You can hold the left key and drag it to any other location you want to move. Okay, when you hold the right key and drag this particular text, it's going to give you an option. Okay, do you want to move it or you want to copy it? hold the right key and drag this particular text to a particular place. Let me to this place. It's going to give you the option. Do you want to move it here? Or do you want to copy it? Do you want to link it? Or do you want to cancel? Okay, so let's say we want to copy it to this place. And it's going to copy this particular text just like that. All right, you can select a particular location. Once you select that location, hold the shift key and you select a second location, it will highlight the whole area in between the first selection and the last selection. You can click on another place and it will still highlight. Okay, to the other place, it will still highlight. Once you hold the shift key, it will keep highlighting the text. You can select a particular text and then you hold the control key and you can select another text in another place. Okay. Once you hold the control key, you are free to select as many texts as you want. And then you can hold this text, you can hold the left key and drag these three texts to any location that you want. And once you lift the mouse button, it's going to drop these three things that you have copied from there. Okay, it's going to move them to that particular location. And another thing you can do is you can select, you can highlight rows from the margin here. You can come to the margin and once you click, it highlights a particular row. It highlights a particular row. You can hold the left key and drag to select multiple rows. Okay. And you can hold the control as well to select series of other multiple rows. And then you can do some other operations at the same time. You can decide to move all of them to a particular place. You can hold the right key and move them to a particular place where it's going to give you the option to select whether to move, to copy, or to cancel, something like that. So the mouse select is also a very, very fantastic and powerful tool to use in Microsoft Word.
All right, guys, thank you so much for being with me up to this point. And I do hope that you have learned something today. If you do, kindly feel free to share with your friends. And don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button to stay connected with this channel for more of our useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.